Okay guys, hello. We have not made a video in forever and I know, but now we are gonna make a video today. We aren't doing much. It's like 1:15, I believe, 1:30. And we just got out of bed, we just got ready. Nothing too special. We gotta put Xavier's shoes on in the car. Mikey's taking it to church. And we are gonna go to Starbucks right
hey guys, now. So we are now at the car wash. Mikey is washing the car. I was gonna help him, but it is super flooded. I don't know if you guys can see, but it is super flooded right there in the middle. And I wore my mochas today, so unless Mikey is trying to buy me new mochas again, I won't be getting out. He's just gonna wash it real quick, dry it real quick, and then I believe we're gonna go to Ulta, and then we're gonna go to Chick-fil-A. He's in the back waiting for his dad to finish cleaning the Subi. We went to Starbucks. I got him a red, well, I originally got him the grilled cheese, because I guess they have grilled cheese out here. I don't know if they have it in Cali. I usually don't order food from Starbucks like that, so I don't know if Kelly has it. But then they were out of the grilled cheese, so then Mikey told them to get us a red velvet loaf, and he was like okay at the speaker thing. And by the time I got to the window, it was like taking forever and we already had our drinks, so we were kind of confused. And then he says he doesn't have the red velvet loaf, so we got stuck with this banana one. I don't know. I just returned my foundation from Ulta, so now we are going, where babe?
Chick-fil-A.
We are going, look at my hair, it does look cute. This was from last night though, because you can tell, look at that. See how nasty it looks? Looks so staticky.
We're gonna go to Chick-fil-A, and Chick-fil-A is like 20 minutes from here. You forgot the A in Chick-fil-A, babe. It's not going. We're having technical difficulties, guys. It's not searching up on Mikey's phone for some reason. And I got a grande because I know I wasn't gonna finish it all. And look, I haven't even finished. It's not even halfway. And look, Mikey got a venti and he hasn't even finished, not even half. You're like quarter ways. And by the way, Mikey stole my Starbucks order. He literally tried it once and that's all the Starbuckses that he's been ordering. Anyways, so I'm gonna try and hurry up and finish my coffee before we go to Chick-fil-A, because Mikey's car only has two cup holders and I'm getting some. Four? Yeah, babe, but there's already one right there. I'm talking about like the center ones. There's two cup holders in the center, and then there's two cup holders on the door, but I'm not putting my cup in the door. That's fine. We are 9 minutes away from Chick-fil-A, so we will see you guys when we get to Chick-fil-A. Guys, so in case you guys do not know, we have now made an up, you can't even see. We have made another stop because Mikey is very, I don't know how to what the word is for it, but if you know the word, then you know the word. Mikey, if there's something wrong with Mikey's car, or Mikey's outfit, or Mikey's hair, or whatever, if there's something wrong with him and he can fix it, he's gonna fix it as soon as he can, even if that means we're gonna be late or he's not gonna be able to go do something because it just irritates him that bad. So we had stopped at a little daycare that was like on the way to Chick-fil-A. And he made a stop because he kept hearing like the scraping of the bottom of his car, which is the cover that holds, like in case of like any fluids like flow out, I guess you can say, like it goes on that. But I'm guessing it works because he just asked me to pull a big piece off. He can't pull the piece off of the tape for some reason, so I'm guessing it's working. But he's a little upset because he says that he needs to pee and he just wants to relax because he does work tomorrow, so. Yeah. And Xavier's exhausted of being in his freaking car. We will see you guys in a Chick-fil-A drive-thru if we make it to Chick-fil-A, when we make it to Chick-fil-A. So, we will see you guys then. So, just wish me luck.
Okay, guys, so we are now at Chick-fil-A, and there's like 30 million cars in front of us because we decided to wait till fucking, this is like everybody's lunch slash early dinner. So now we have to wait for all these cars. But Mikey fixed his car. Thankfully, yeah, went to AutoZone and bought the 3M tape and was getting mad because one side of the 3M tape was not working. This is all we're doing today. We're not doing much because there's really nothing to do in here at Reno. And we're actually not trying to spend a lot of money because we're leaving. That's so crazy to say that we're finally leaving. But I honestly can't complain because I haven't been here for a year. You know? Like, I can't be like, oh my god, it's been a year. I want to leave. Yeah.
Another month.
So we are moving back to Cali in March. So we're kind of excited about that. But
vlogs at Disneyland, Dodger games.
I know. We're actually going to be able to do a lot of things because here in Reno, there's not really much. Like, to it, I mean, he has a couple of friends that he works with, and I have a couple of friends that I work with, and they still say that Reno is not it. They have a water park here, but it's literally the highest that it gets is probably like 80.
But then you can't even go in the summer for half the time because it's smoke everywhere.
Yeah, that is true. I didn't think about that, baby.
So
right.
For like 6 out of 12 months, it's either smoke or snow.
Yeah.
So it's like,
so there's really no point of like a water park. And I mean, they have like, literally, if you were to come to Reno, they would tell you like all about their bowling alley and their mini golf. Like, that's all they
and
really
the hiking
have.
Trails that they have.
Yeah, and the hiking trails. Like, that's all Reno really has. I mean, it is a big chunk for us because we're so used to being like 30 minutes away from LA. So it is like
Orange County, all the clubs, all the,
yeah, everything. Like,
every,
we're literally
park, every baseball, football stadium.
Yeah.
The beach.
Mhm.
And we got lakes just like here. They can kiss our ass.
I know. Like, yeah. One of my managers
away.
That I worked with, he was like, "Oh my god, yeah, we have Lake Tahoe," and it's like, "Okay, bro, we have like 6 lakes up in fucking going towards Big Bear. There's like 6 lakes going to Big Bear, and then we have Big Bear Lake." So I don't know. If y'all are thinking about moving out of California, do not do it. I mean, to move back to Cali, because we're just going to be saving a lot more money. And we're going to be, like, around our family more. And we'll actually be able to, like, go out with my best friend, with his friends. Like, we'll be able to actually do things that we want to do as a couple or individually, because now we can do it. But right here in Reno, there's really
to finally eat something else other than Chick-fil-A, because it's the only good thing that Reno has.
Yeah, Reno has like all of California's basics, like Taco Bell, Jack in the Box, In-N-Out, Chick-fil-A. What else do they have here? I mean,
just the basics, the basic American
BJ's, but it's like Buffalo, Wingstop, but it's kind of like, to me, those places, like, even in Cali, I would get them, but every here and there. I think the most out of everything I would get is Chick-fil-A.
Like, there's no, like, places to go get tacos or kind of salad fries. Or,
yeah, there's nothing. I mean, there's not,
there's no, like, other burger spots other than In-N-Out. Like, you can't go to Tommy's, or you can't go to
Well, they
to
have
the
Habit, but, I mean,
but, yeah, we got the Habit, too.
Yeah, that is true. Like, the Habit.
We have one Five Guys, and it closes at 5. Like, dude.
Yeah, Five Guys closes at 5.
And it's the only one.
And it's not, it's far from here too. Well, not from here, but it's far from us at least. That's at least like 25 minute drive, I think. It's just very, I think we're just used to having like surround, like we're used to living where we live in California. So
here's just basic American shit. There's no like meds, there's no good Mexican food, no Chinese food, no Japanese food.
We tried Chinese like the first month?
The first month.
Like the first month or two that we were here, and I'm like big on reading reviews, so I was looking at all these places and I was reading the reviews, and one of the reviews was like, oh, if you're from LA, like obviously we're not from LA, but like that's kind of like the closest that we are from. So they were like, oh, if you're from LA, like you're gonna love it here because
Like, it tastes like one of the places that...
Chinatown.
Yeah, there you go. From Chinatown and LA or whatever. Something about Chinatown and LA that it's the same. It tastes the same and it's amazing. So I was like, bet. I was so hyped because Chinese is like my favorite. So we went and tried it and it was horrible. Like, we literally, as soon as we walked in, they didn't even have a menu. Like, Mikey didn't walk in, he stayed in the car, but they didn't even have a menu. They literally had like a whiteboard this big, listing with all like their things and their prices with a whiteboard marker. Subi!
Already got into like 2-3 accidents in Reno.
Yeah, Mikey's gotten hit a couple of times. Mikey got hit in the front, that's why he had to get his new bumper. And then he got hit in the back. And when I was washing your car today, I saw the mark. Did you see it?
Oh, that's the mark. Oh.
It's just like a skinny, like, yeah. That's all it is, though. Mikey got hit by a SUV. And then Mikey's car literally almost could have exploded on us. His car's turbo broke.
The sensor flew into the turbo and the turbo broke.
Yeah.
So I had to get a brand new turbo.
So he has been wanting a turbo, and with us moving from Reno to California, that was most definitely not going to happen anytime soon.
But it had to happen.
But for some reason, it happened. That's something that he wanted for Christmas, and I was going to try and get it for him, but with us moving to Cali, it's just such a big cost shock, right? A cost shock change.
But the turbo I got was cheaper than the stock one.
Yeah. So it kind of ended up working out for some reason. You know, how
so
things just work out.
A little quicker. It makes around 400 to the wheels now.
Yeah.
Before it was making like 350.
But now when we get back to Cali, since we're going to be saving money more, we are going to try and get him a new intercooler.
And the car will be full bolt-ons. That's all I need. New intercooler. That's it.
He wants to get the top intercooler. I think he should get the front, but I mean, he's already having legal issues with this car, so imagine with the front. Like, I know you said that you wanted to get it tuned. Are you still gonna get it tuned?
Yeah, I'm gonna have to.
No, I know, but are you gonna? No, like I'm saying down here.
Yeah, I'm gonna come back here. We're gonna do another trip up here to get it tuned.
I'm not doing another trip, so that will be a vlog that Mikey will have to do for you guys, because I'm not coming fucking down back to Reno. Fuck that. Mikey's probably gonna come back with one of his friends, so.
Because the tuner here is really good.
He believes that the tuner here is giving him better readings than the one in Cali.
And the car feels smoother.
Yeah. But his tune, like, obviously I wasn't there when he got his last tune. But this tune, it feels like the Subi is, like, flying and it's skidding onto the floor. That makes any sense?
Like,
it feels like it's flying a little bit above the ground. And then at parts and times of the road, it feels like it's like that.
The other tune, it felt like it was faster because it pushed you back.
Yeah, the last tune was more like, it felt like a roller coaster. Yeah, like an aggressive roller coaster that's, like, when you get off, you're like, oh, my neck. Like, that's what
the Subi felt like. This tune is faster, like 40 wheel
horsepower
faster.
You know what this tune? This tune feels like the...
It's an airplane.
No, what is that ride?
Like the motion ride.
The motion ride. You know when they like pull you like to go through the, what is it called? The galaxy or whatever?
Yeah.
To go through the stars? That's how it feels like when you're like driving it. Like it feels crazy. Like
oh, no, it's better. It's faster and it's just smoother.
Yeah.
And it's healthier. I get less knock.
We're moving to Cali. We are super excited. It's going to be super hype. So be ready for the vlogs, because as soon as we hit the Cali grounds, we're going to be out in those streets. Right, babe?
Mm-hmm.
No, maybe not the first, like, couple of months. Like, we're all like, fuck yeah, we're going to be out in the streets. But realistically...
we'll still be vlogging, though.
No, yeah, we'll still be vlogging. There'll still be stuff to do, but we won't be, like, out in the streets for, like, at least a month.
Cruises.
Yeah.
All my Subi friends are down there.
Everything is, we'll see, we'll, like, what Mikey does, like, some more, like, Subis, cruises, races, like, all that stuff that he does. And then, like, me hanging out with my friends or my family. So you guys will see, like, a lot of different things. Like, it's not just gonna be just, like, us three all the time on camera going, doing family Disney trips or any of that. We're just gonna be doing... Yeah, but it's not gonna be, like, that's all they're seeing is, like, family outing, family outing, family outing. Like, we need a break from this kid. We spent a whole 10 months
straight.
10 months straight with this child, no break. So as soon as we get to Cali, we are throwing him to whoever can catch him.
All right, guys. So we never really did an outro, but we are like 5 minutes away. From